Welcome home and welcome to Sweeter Than Honey. Will you pray with me? Dear Father in heaven, how great are your goodness and mercy to us on our earth, who are subjects to misery and death. May our hearts be strengthened through your goodness and through the saving power of your nature, revealed to us in Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Protect and bless us today. May your Spirit help us find your ever-present kindness and mercy. Praise be your name forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God's words for today comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verse 31 through 43. Matthew chapter 13, verse 31 through 43, and we'll be reading from the NLT, the New Living Translation. I will read it for us, so please carefully follow along and hear the word of the Lord. He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it grows, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until all of it was leavened. Jesus told the crowds all these things in parables. Without a parable, he told them nothing. This was to fulfill what has been spoken through the prophet. I will open my mouth to speak in parables. I will proclaim what has been hidden since the foundation. Then he left the crowds and went into the house. And the disciples approached him, saying, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field." He answered, "The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one. And the enemy who sowed them is the devil, and the harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out his kingdom all causes of sin and evildoers. And they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the rigorous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen. Amen." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. In our passage today, we have 2 different parables that Jesus tells. One is what Jesus is telling, and the parable is, and why Jesus uses them, and the one explanation of the parable of the weeds. For today, I would like us to focus in on the 2 parables. The first parable that we find in our reading today is the parable of the mustard seed. Jesus says that the kingdom of God is like a mustard seed. A mustard seed is small. It's very tiny. It's actually very, very tiny. I don't know if you've seen it. It's almost like a speck of dust. And yet, this tiny seed, we get something amazing. And the amazing thing happening is that when it gets sown and it grows into a plant, it produces a plant that is 2 to 6 feet tall. And in some rare cases, it can grow up to tall as 9 feet tall. The mustard seed plant is not a tree, but it's a shrub. And it is compared in this parable, the small mustard seed, as to a lowly, it's seen as lowly compared to almost an imperial tree. The imperial tree was a sign of empire, was a sign of power in those times. But Jesus is saying, he is a king who operates on meekness and lowliness. Jesus rides into a Jerusalem on a donkey. This parable is saying the lowliness of the kingdom, and then at last, in the end of the ages, there will be greatness. Just like the mustard seed that starts out so small, but later will become a great plant. The second parable is a parable of the yeast, how the kingdom multiplies and grows like that of when the yeast is added to flour. At the end of the day, EMS, our calling to this kingdom, our calling of this kingdom is lowly of stature and status. Our glory and strength do not come in the ways that we think they will come in. It does not come by show of force. It does not come by seducing others, but rather the glory of what we are doing, the glory of what is happening through us and in us, is in the works of God. Just as Jesus came to serve and be a lonely person for us, we should too. And with this in mind, when we do this works, when God works through our humbleness and our meekness and our lowliness, he will multiply us. He will bring about his gospel and his glory and his grace upon us. So today there are 2 parables. I hope that we're called to first a lowly status, to come in meekness, to come and love, to come and forgive, to come and give and sacrifice to those in need. And then through those, may God work wonders through us. May God work miracles through us. And may God ever multiply his kingdom. Let's pray. God, we thank you for calling us. We thank you that you are calling us to meekness and to lowliness, to giving, to loving. Father, at times we admit that it is not easy to be meek. It is not easy to be weak. It is not easy to serve, but you are calling us to do so. So help us to do it faithfully. Help us to do it rightfully. And help us do so that your kingdom may be blessed and your kingdom may be proclaimed. And through this, will you work wonders. Through our lowliness, through our meekness, will you show your love? Will you continue to grow your kingdom? And will you continue to grow this church and grow EMS? So we thank you for loving us. In Jesus Christ and me pray. Amen.